What is a deferred sales trust? Because I'm sure a lot of our listeners haven't heard of that before.
A deferred sales trust is a manufactured installment sale. It's a specialized installment sale. Your listeners may know it as a seller carryback.
Okay, and what does that, in layman's terms, what does that mean?
So, Seth, if I'm going to buy a deal from you for $10 million, imagine you got a zero basis and you owe $4 million tax if you don't do some kind of tax deferral. I may come to you, Seth, and say, Seth, I'm going to give you a $3 million down payment. Would you carry a note for seven? And you say yes. In that scenario, Seth, you've received $3 million in actual receipt. Therefore, you owe tax on that three. But that other seven is what's called a deferral. It's a seller carryback. You became the bank and you carried paper. Therefore, until and if I pay you back that seven, you're in a tax deferral state. The tax is, the capital gains tax is not triggered.
And then obviously, instead of paying it all at once, let's say you were paying me $1 million a year for 7 years, I would pay that, the tax only on that portion every year over time.
You got it. And so you're going to pay it in a pro rata amount, which is generally why someone might do a seller carryback, so their income is not through the roof on any one particular year.
Okay. And how did this come about for you? How did you discover this? How did you start this business?
2008, something happened, Seth. You and your listeners might know about it. But let me back up 2 years before that. I started at Marcus & Millichap, helping people buy and sell commercial real estate in Sacramento, California, mainly multifamily. And I saw the blood in the streets when everything hit the fan and people lost a lot. And some lost it all with their finances. Part of the challenge was what's called the 1031 exchange. And for your listeners, that's just a strategy where you can trade a piece of real estate for like-kind real estate to defer capital gains tax. But people were selling at these record numbers in 05 and 06, and they were really excited. They were glad to get those numbers. But then they had to turn around and buy and overpay for properties and take on debt. And that debt became a place where they got hurt. So after the aftermath and everything hit in 2009, I learned about an alternative called a deferred sales trust. And I said, what is this? Why haven't I heard about it? This seems like it's too good to be true. How do we know it's legal? And I started to study this structure. And my manager at the time brought in a gentleman who spoke on the structure, who's now my business partner. And essentially, I started to learn about it and started to study it. I have my Series 22, my Series 63. But here's the key. I was looking for ways to help my clients solve problems. Problems beyond the 1031s, problems of feeling trapped by capital gains tax, okay? According to the American Bankers Association, there's $17 trillion, Seth, that will pass from one generation to the next in the next 20 years, and this is known as the largest wealth transfer in the history of the planet. And in 2008, a lot of those baby boomers lost a lot. And so fast forward, they're 10 years older, and they're looking for solutions to retire from the toilets, trash, and liability without getting completely wiped out with 30 to 50% of their gain. So this fits such a need for people who want to be more passive, who want to pay off debt, who want liquidity. I couldn't help but launch this company to educate as many people as I can.
Awesome.
You have just listened to another information-packed episode of Capital Gains Tax Solutions with Brett Swartz. We hope you enjoyed today's show and found it helpful. Visit capitalgainstaxsolutions.com to access the show notes and to access more resources. Don't forget to leave a review and join us again next time.